Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're having a great time. Today we're back with some latest space updates for you. We'll start with a Starship update as SpaceX reveals their first orbital Starship, equipped with Raptor engines capable of propelling it through the vacuum of space, following a discussion regarding Musk's reaction to a recently revealed interview and a quick look into German startups becoming future competitors with their mini rockets. We'll continue with a discussion on Japanese lunar lander company Ispace. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Now, let's start with SpaceX's Starship SN20. Elon Musk has recently revealed a photo of Starship SN20, which is slated to be used for orbital flight, which shows that SpaceX teams have installed 3 sea-level Raptors and 3 vacuum-optimized Raptor engines at the bottom of the vehicle. On the 4th of August, Elon Musk tweeted with the photo of the Raptor-stacked SN20 that all 6 engines mounted to the first orbital Starship. Just a short time before, SpaceX had stacked 29 engines, 9 gimballing engines for the central part, and 20 fixed engines for the boost part on Super Heavy Booster 4 and rolled it out for several upcoming tests. According to SpaceX's production table, this Booster 4 was rolled out nearly a month after the earlier rollout of Booster 3. Just after completing the earlier milestone of stacking scores of engines with half a day on the booster, Musk has now put forward the ready-stacked SN20. This certainly shows the glimpse of SpaceX's progress in carrying out the orbital launch as soon as possible. Starship SN20 is the first orbital-class prototype of Starship SN series. Earlier prototypes were only suborbital. Not only that, SN20 is the first Starship prototype to have vacuum-optimized Raptor engines installed inside it. Earlier, SpaceX teams did not even try to install even 1 vacuum-optimized Raptor engine inside the Starship prototypes. As known, out of the 6 Raptor engines, 3 sea-level Raptors are gimballing and the remaining 3 vacuum-optimized ones were fixed and are equipped with much larger bell nozzles to create effective and greater thrust and vacuum. With these RVAC engines installed on Starship, SN20 becomes the most powerful orbital stage in space. According to some reports, this orbital-class Starship is capable of producing 1,250 metric tons of thrust to propel in space. After a few hours of outfitting the 6 Raptor engines, SpaceX has now installed the nose cone to define the basic structure. Ship 20 and Booster 4 will form an integrated vehicle together to support Starship's maiden orbital test flight. The SpaceX team is working day and night to attach S20's nose with the tank section. The first orbital class Super Heavy Booster 4, B4, is already attached by SpaceX to a huge crane in the launch pad. Super Heavy B4 was picked up 30 to 40 meters freely from its transport stand and cautiously lowered onto the launch table after a minor passing storm around 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. As mentioned, this is the first prototype to have mounting points for full 6 Raptors, so before SpaceX considers it ready for test flight, multiple important checkpoints needed to be validated, especially exhaustive proof test simulating thrust of those engines by hydraulic rams. This could be also applicable for Super Heavy Booster 4, having 29 Raptor engines installed in a breathtaking 14 hours of extraordinary assembling process. As 5 of these engines were never static-fired, they may go through isolated quality testing at SpaceX's McGregor Development Facility. Good news is, irrespective of the readiness to get fired, we can see a fully integrated Starship rocket stacked in the launch pad. Moving to our next update, Elon Musk agreed that NASA has saved SpaceX with their $1.5 billion contract. SpaceX and Tesla are 2 most renowned companies in the world owned by Elon Musk. While talking about SpaceX, the idea of reusable rockets was brought out by them first as a private space agency. Earlier, only the government-owned NASA had the space shuttle as a reusable vehicle. Tesla also has brought revolution in producing electric cars. Both the companies had succeeded profoundly. Specifically, while talking about SpaceX, Musk had stated that the journey was not so good in the beginning. On the 4th of August, Tesla owners of Silicon Valley have recently revealed a video of Musk's interview on NASA's contract in their Twitter page. If we look back, SpaceX was facing serious hurdles in between 2006 and 2008. Failure of three launches of the Falcon 1 rocket had sent them to near bankruptcy. The fourth Falcon launch was a success, and following that, NASA provided them with a $1.5 billion contract. The nature of the contract was not revealed immediately, but later it was revealed the contract was related to NASA's commercial cargo contract. In the recently shared video, it showed that Musk had stated that NASA had provided them with a $1.5 billion contract. Musk had said in the video, "I just spill it out. I love you guys." When Musk was inquired whether NASA had saved SpaceX, Musk replied, "Yeah, they did. I'll tell you, that was definitely helpful." After the interview got released on Twitter, Musk wrote that it's true, showing that he still has the same feelings for NASA. Feelings of Musk much emboldened when he further tweeted that, "I do love NASA, always have." Good news for SpaceX lovers is that the number of customers for Starlink Internet has crossed the mark of 90,000. Starlink now has customers from over 12 countries. Our next update is based on German startup companies. Germany is becoming an important name in the space race. They're working on three projects to bring forth mini launchers for launching small satellites in orbit. Germany's private sector space companies are now planning to compete with U.S. space agencies with their mini-launch vehicles. In May 2021, High Impulse, a Baden-Württemberg-based Germany company, tested their rocket engines on the Shetland Isles. Their engine uses candle wax fuel to enhance work efficiency. Christian Schmeier, High Impulse co-founder, said, "Our technology is advanced enough to serve the mini-launcher market." ISAR Aerospace is the second company, and they've yet to test engines of their Spectrum rocket to be launched by 2022. Rocket Factory Augsburg, RFA, had carried out the first successful test of its RFA-1 rocket in July. RFA-1 ignited its engines for nearly 8 seconds at their testing site in Sweden. Jorn Spermann, RFA's operational director, said the rocket's stage combustion system will allow 30% more payload to be put into orbit. According to a report, these German startups are planning to build a fleet of nearly 20 to 40 partially reusable rockets to easily accommodate multiple launches in a year. Spermann stated, "We want to create a Henry Ford moment for space travel eventually," hinting towards havoc production of launchers. They're planning to compete with SpaceX and other big space companies in this mini-launch market. Regarding this mini-launcher project, Schmeier said, "A large rocket is like a long-distance bus which drops all its passengers at the same stop. A micro-launcher works like a taxi, placing these satellites exactly where the client wants them." According to estimates of ISAR Aerospace, the mini-launcher market will eventually increase to more than 30 billion euros by 2027. With small and medium-sized satellites making up around a third of it. Small-sized satellites will increase efficiency and reduce cost of launch. RFA stated, "We'll be able to load 1.3 tons of material for 5 million euros, a price significantly lower than the competition at 3,850 euros per kilo." Now let's take a look at our last update regarding Ispace. On the 4th of August, Ispace, a Tokyo-based lunar lander company, announced that they'd raised $46 million in Series C funding round. This funding will help Ispace in future moon missions. Incubate Fund, a Japanese venture capital fund, was leading the seven investors in the funding round. Adding this new round, Ispace has raised nearly $195.5 million of funding. Earlier in 2020, Ispace got $28 million in a Series B round. Takeshi Hakamada, founder and chief executive of Ispace, said, We're very grateful to our investors for supporting Ispace to develop a high-frequency lunar transportation platform. There are an increasing number of stakeholders entering this ecosystem from the development and investment side. This Series C round will help in development of lunar lander missions, Mission 2 and Mission 3. According to a report, Mission 1 is planned to launch in 2022, mostly funded from Series B round, aboard SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. By 2023, Mission 2 will be launched using the same lander. Ispace is building a much larger lander in their U.S. assembly site for the Mission 3, slated to launch in 2024. Ispace has been assembling their Mission 1 lander in Ariane Group facility in Germany since last month. As stated in a report, the Mission 1 lander will have JAXA's, that's Japanese Space Agency, tiny transformable lunar robot cameras from Canadensis, a Canadian company, and a rover named Rashid, built by Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center, as payloads. Earlier in July of this year, the Lunar Industry Vision Council issued a report providing suggestions for the Japanese government to develop lunar projects. Ispace is also part of this council. The suggestions proposed for a next-gen Planet 6.0 project covering both Earth and the Moon. That's all for today, and oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.